Welcome one, welcome all. Take a squat, pop a seat. I'm your host, Tony Spooks Garbanzo, and we're here, my favorite time of year, Halloween. When you jamokes call me with your problems, I laugh and give you half-baked advice I found from Wikipedia. This is my assistant, Christian. I owe his mom a favor, so he's here now. I don't know what he does, but he's here. He's a disappointment to us all. All right, caller one, you're on the line.
Yes, hello. Oh, I'm sorry, Mr. Garbanzo. I need to take my Colgate whitener out.
It's better. Yes, hello, Mr. Garbanzo. I just recently moved from my home in Transylvania to one of your American states, Pennsylvania?
Oh, we got ourselves a vampire here. Is Transylvania one of those countries where they don't really, you know what freedom is?
Oh, my country has plenty of freedom. And how can you say your country has freedom when you can't even take a thermos full of blood through customs?
You know, TSA, they got the things about the fluids. I don't want to go into it. Anyways, welcome to the US of A, Mr. Von Counter. How can I help you on this fine evening?
Well, sir, I've grown quite lonely this fall. I simply don't understand American women.
You're not alone on that one, my friend. I'm not even sure they understand themselves sometimes. Through my last 7 divorces, I've learned a thing or two. But that's why the doctor's here. The cat's out of the bag. I'm here to help you. So, talk to me.
Thank you. That's really wonderful to hear, Tony. If I can call you that?
It's Tony, you kid.
That's what I said. But, Tony, I'm 847 years old. I can't say I've had 7 divorces. I don't even know how that happens. But I have suffered my fair share of heartbreak. I was bitter, locked in my manor, alone with my bats and hounds, cold, and so alone. Not anymore, Tony. I feel like a schoolboy again. Oh, it sounds silly, I know, but I think I'm in love.
Oh, kid, love's a witch. It really is. You gotta get out of there while you still can. Unless she cute.
What?
Is she a real lady, the fox? A real good old 1-2 punch? Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
All those things and more, Tony. What I'm saying is...
I'm not done yet. Is she a smoker? A hottie? A dime? A dazzler? A dame? Another borderline offensive term for a woman who's attractive?
Please, Tony, I get it. You're making me cringe.
All right, my dude, but the real question is... She cute?
You should see the neck on this one.
Hmm?
She drives me wild. Her veins are just full of the good stuff. And I don't mean cholesterol.
Alright, tough guy. This is a family show. Look at little Theremin over there. He's scarred for the rest of his life. Hey, Brisket, I'm not paying you to play Among Us with your band friends. Get to work. See? Cut the feed. We're moving on to the next caller. Goodbye.
Hi, this is Stephanie.
Oh, TV Demon, how you doing?
TV Demon's my mom's name. Just call me Stephanie. Oh, I probably shouldn't have said that. I'm having boyfriend problems, and I don't know if he watches your show or not.
Well, Steph, if he doesn't watch the show, I can tell you he's not a keeper.
Mr. Know-It-All is every Wednesday at 2:30 a.m. only on WBXLTV.
So, I don't want to, say who he is, but I can give you an idea.
Now, I can't see because this is a phone call, so Blitzen, give me a little, sketchy sketch. That is the worst picture I've ever seen. Oh, the Towhead! What a guy. Great kid, wonderful person. Oh, I love him so much. So, what's your problem again?
Well, he drove me to Wyoming and just dropped me off. And he's never done that before, like, ever. And he let me out in the middle of a cornfield. He doesn't even have his license.
Okay, well, hold up. All right, and let's run it back a little bit. Just take it, like, whoop. Okay, bring it back. Wyoming? You're trying to pull a little sick joke on me? You think Wyoming's a real place? A cornfield? How do you even get service in a cornfield? Huh? Explain.
Yeah, I have service, but like not for long, I don't think.
Who's your carrier? You got Verizon?
All right, like I'm actually in a cornfield in Wyoming. Like, can you please help me?
So you used an emergency phone call to reach my show. I love to see it. My fans are so dedicated. Oh, best of luck to you, Steph. I'll talk to you in a little bit. I hope everything goes well with them.
Hello?
Next caller, you're on.
Oh my god, am I on? Oh, sweet salami. Hi, Tony. Oh, hold on. I gotta take a picture of this. Hold on. Hello? Can you hear me? Hi, Tony. I just love your show. I just love you so much, too.
Oh, look who it is. It's the crazy lady who's been calling us for the past 15 seasons, and we've been avoiding her call every time because she's on a no-call list. Wonder how this could have happened, Thurston? Oh, that's right. I can custom with a pumpkin. Well,
Tony, you just have to meet my son. Ethan! Get in here! Ethan, come on. Just look at my little schnookums. Look at that little rump.
Ma, I got this. Hey, Tony. Sorry about me, Mom.
It's okay. She seems like a real loving lady. So, what's your problem, kid? Come talk to Uncle Tony.
Well, sir, I'm a ghost. And ever since I died, it's been really hard finding love. I swear, I'm really attractive. I mean, we're talking chiseled cheekbones, rock-solid abs. You can tell. Just by my voice.
You sound like a real catch.
You don't know the half of it, Tony. But nobody can see me, because I'm a ghost. I mean, there are some cuties out there with a sixth sense, but none of them are for me, you know? I swear, I'm a machine, but it's just really hard when you're a disembodied voice.
How'd you die?
I'm glad you asked, Tony. I can't go into the details. Apparently NDAs are binding beyond the grave, but I can't tell you that I'll never go back to the WBXL studio. But, Tony, I need your help. Am I doomed to spend my afterlife alone?
Well, that's my cue to move on, because I indeed do not handle emotions well. Whoever you are, hang in there, big guy. You're on with Tony Spooks.
Hi, I'm Jack.
Oh, I'm sorry, I gotta go.
Wait, no. I'm not Jack. I'm Kennedy dressed as Jack. I can't even imagine being Jack. I'm just going to a Halloween party. I want to see if my costume was good.
Wait, so you're going as that Jack McManus kid from that one show where they do the funny things?
Baker News. Do you watch it?
I don't really care for it. They're like Saturday Night Live with less humor and more ridiculous amounts of censorships. That should be the motto.
Well, I'm going to a Halloween party and I want to make sure people would like my costume.
Where'd you get your costume?
I found it.
Neat. Have fun at your party. All right, who is this? I will not hesitate to press this button. You better say something real quick here, bucko. You're wasting your own time. I'm getting paid for this. You're not getting paid for this. If you ask for a raise, I'm throwing this pumpkin at you.
I'm sorry, Mr. Garbanzo. I'm really shy. I just never know what to say. I guess that's why I called you. I can't talk to girls. I just can't.
Aiden, are you still doing this character? Or is this just you? Is this a cry for help?
Yeah, sorry. I guess I just thought you could help. I don't know.
It's all right, bud. It's okay. Don't worry. We can definitely talk after the show. I'll have you just call him and we'll answer it. We'll pick it up. It'll be perfect. We'll have a nice good two-hour conversation.
Fine. I'll see you.
Well, I'm sorry about that one, folks. Aiden just... he has to be in everything. Back to the real people. We got 8 more hours to fill. Next caller, you're on with Sir Anthony Spooketh the First.
The harbinger of hell, destroyer of light, the most vile creature ever to walk on the earth. Mephistopheles, at your service.
Fisto? Is that really you, buddy? I haven't seen you since like 06.
Tony? Tony? Antone, Garbanzo Bean. It's been too long, my friend. 06? We must have been rooming together back at Stanford.
The most evil place on the planet.
That's right, bro. Delta Kappa Alpha Cinco, represent. How you feel? How are the kids? How are the kids doing?
The kids are fine, they're doing good. I can't believe you got your own show there, Anton. You're killing it.
I told you that degree in blacksmithing and bagpiping arts and sciences would pay off. How's that liberal arts degree doing for you, Mr. Big Shot?
Those must be trick-or-treaters. I gotta go hand out toothbrushes, only to discuss one of the Bean Boozled jelly beans and some Snickers with little razor blades in them. It's a classic. I'll see you at the reunion and have fun on your subpar television show.
That's the best review we've ever gotten. In all seriousness, Halloween safety is very important. Kids, be careful. I once found a miniature Rudy Giuliani in my Werther's Originals. Oh, I'm being told that's all the time we have? I thought we were on for like another 7.5 hours. Is there anything on after us? No? All right. Well, Tristan, play us off. Thanks for tuning in, everyone. That was horrible. Just play the tape instead. Have a very happy Halloween and an even better All Saints Day. I'm Tony Spooks Garbanzo, and it's past my bedtime. Oh, and also this is Baker News on WBXLTV. Yeah, gotcha. That's the whole time. All right, good night, everybody.